so well acquainted.
Yeah.
alive. Yes. I'm still here.
Yes.
I'm still alive.
Yes.
In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me. In spite of calamity, ladies and gentlemen, God still has a plan for you. And the devil should have taken you out when he had the chance. Because that realization that God still has a plan for you is what the enemy didn't want you to come through. You made it. You made it. In spite of calamity. Still here. You're still alive. You're still here. You're still alive. And the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. You shall live and not die. You shall live and not die. You've got some good work to declare. God has a good work for you. I know the thoughts that I have for you. They're plans of good. Not of bad, not of evil. Not gonna tear you apart, make things difficult for you. It's gonna bring you a hope and a future. I'm so glad I made it. So glad I made it. Woo! So glad I made it. I made it through. Could have given up, but I made it through. Could have thrown in the towel, but I made it through. Could have lost my mind, but I made it through. Could have been sitting somewhere half crazy, but I made it through. Could have been strung out on drugs, but I made it through. Could have been an alcoholic somewhere, drinking my life away, but I made it through. So glad I made it. So glad I made it. So glad, so glad, so glad. You made it.
Yeah.
You made it.
Yeah.
You made it. Hallelujah. We're taking direction from the Holy Ghost.
I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my pleas for mercy. Because he inclined his ear to me, therefore I will call on him as long as I live.
Hallelujah.
The snares of death encompassed me. The pangs of Sheol laid hold on me. I suffered distress and anguish. Then I called on the name of the Lord. Oh Lord, I pray, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is merciful. The Lord preserves the simple. When I was brought low, he saved me. Return, O my soul, to your rest, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with you. For you have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I believed even when I spoke, I am greatly afflicted. I said in my heart, all mankind are liars. What shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation. I will call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Oh Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your maidservant. You have loosed my bonds. I will offer to you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. In the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So you can use me in my
you have been indicted. You've been indicted due to your past, failures, mistakes, slip-ups, losses. Some of you have been indicted, perhaps because of generational curses.
My Lord.
Things that have been passed down from generation to generation in your family. Your family or the people that you associate with have a certain reputation. And you've been indicted. The enemy has tried to keep you captive. And I said that God is not going to be able to use you. Nothing is going to come out of your life. But hear the word of the Lord. Although your situations have tried to lock you up and place chains on you, know that your Redeemer lives. That you have been redeemed. You have been justified. The scripture tells us that the Pharisees were coming up to Jesus and the disciples. And that whenever they would ask the disciples about Jesus, the disciples wouldn't answer, but Jesus would step in and answer. They would ask, what's going on? Why are these people doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath? Every time Jesus would step in and answer them. And that's what has occurred in your life. That although you've been indicted, you feel like these chains have been on you. And that the people around you, your family, your friends, has a, you know, you've got to have to deal with this. You're going to have to pay for this. You're going to have to suffer because of this. This thing that you've done, this slip up and this loss. You've got a Redeemer. And his name is Jesus.
Yes.
You've got a Redeemer, and his name is Jesus. And he's come to take the chains off you. He's come to loose the bands. You're just saying, I call on you. You hear me. He hears you. You've been crying for quite some long, from some time. Crying out to God. He has heard every tear, every prayer. I said it right. He's heard every tear. He's heard every tear.
Hallelujah.
My tears mean something. They say something. He sees all. He hears all. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. We don't work it right here. This is your day. This is your day. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 7, it says, in him we have redemption through his blood. The forgiveness of sins in accordance with riches of God's grace. In him we have redemption through his blood. New Living Translation said, he is so rich in kindness and grace. Listen to this. That he purchased our freedom with the blood of his son and forgave our sins. This freedom that's in this place, it's been bought. Your freedom has been bought.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You've been justified. So in life, in people, in your crew, people who you may come in contact with would tell you, and they would speak ill over you.
Yes.
They wouldn't speak blessings. They won't be able to celebrate when God is taking you to another level. You got to do like the devil. Talk to the hand.
Yes. Yes.
Talk to Jesus.
Yes.
That's probably what the disciples said to the Pharisees. Talk to Jesus.
Yes.
I've been justified. That freedom. That those mind games that the enemy tries to put in your mind saying that you don't deserve this freedom. It's been bought, baby. It's been bought. So if Jesus paid it for you, why not live it? Why not walk it? Be free. Be free. Be free. It's been paid for. It's been paid for. Isaiah 53, verse 5, it says, "But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him."
It was. Yes. Yes.
Oh, yes.
The punishment that brought us peace, it was upon him.
That's right.
He was punished so that you might have peace.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Why not walk in it?
Hallelujah.
Why not walk in it?
Yes.
He was punished. New Living Translation says, "But he was pierced for our rebellion."
Yes.
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 Crushed for our sins.
Yes.
He was beaten so we could be whole.
My God.
He was whipped so that we could be healed.
Yes. Yes.
Why not walk in it?
Yes. Yes.
Why not walk in it?
Yes.
He was beaten.
My God.
Somebody was beaten so that you could be whole.
Yes.
In your heart and in your mind.
Yes.
Receive it.
Yes.
Receive it.
Thank you.
Receive it.
Yes.
It's been paid for.
Yes.
It's been bought.
Yes.
Yes.
It's yours if you want it. It's yours if you want it. So knowing this, that you've got a Redeemer who paid the price for you. Knowing this, what are you going to do with it? That's what I asked you this morning. What are you going to do with it? You've got some good information here. It's like the government being informed of some top secret information. And then a disaster comes, a tragedy comes, and society says, "Well, you had this information. You didn't do nothing about it."
Yes, yes, yes.
What
yes,
did you
yes.
do with it?
My God.
I asked you this morning. You have this information. It's not a secret.
Yeah, it is.
What are you going to do with it?
Take it.
That's right. Take it. I suggest this. Scripture says, "Let the redeemed of the Lord say so."
Yes.
I still feel like I'm in lack. I still feel like everything is out of control. Pastor, you don't know what I was doing the other day. You don't know what I did hours before I got here.
Yes.
He was pierced for your rebellion.
Yes. Thank you. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
He was pierced for your rebellion. He was pierced for your sin. The scripture says that the wages of sin is what?
Yes. Yes.
But the gift of God
yes.
is eternal life.
Yes. Thank you for the blood.
We thank God for his grace and his mercy. Thank God for this gift of Jesus Christ. Because if the truth be told, you ought to thank God for not striking you down.
Yes.
He was pierced for your rebellion.
That's right.
He was beaten.
Jesus.
So you can be made whole. That's our God. So what are you going to do with it? Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so.
Okay.
But I don't feel like I've come out fully yet. Speak a word over yourself.
Amen. That's right. That's right.
Speak over yourself. Speak to your situation. Speak to those mountains. You've got some mountains. Some mountains that need to be moved, do you not?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Speak to them. And if you understand the power in the name of Jesus, you speak to them in the name of Jesus.
That's right. Yes. Hallelujah.
Looking at your situation, looking at your dead situation, you're saying, can these dry bones live?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Can I make it out of this dry situation?
Yes.
Can I make it out of this dead place?
Yes.
If I got Jesus, And I know that he lives. And the price that he paid, I'm going to speak over myself. And I'm going to walk through. Keep on riding. God has given you dreams. He's given you visions for your life. He showed you pieces of your destiny.
Yes. That's right.
If what he's shown you, if what God has shown you has not come to pass, if that is not coming into the realization of what you see, keep on riding.
Amen.
Keep on riding.
Yes.
It's not over. Keep on riding. So yes is the answer. You can make it out of this dead place. Yes.
Yes.
It ain't going to be dry forever. Know that God has a destiny and a plan for you if you just keep on going. We're going to tell our story. A friend of mine is a publisher, and he asked me about 4 months ago, he said, PJ, you ever going to tell this story? And I said, maybe. Maybe one day. I don't know. Maybe one day. He said, it'll be a great story. Scripture says that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony.
That's right.
Do you know that you've been over, that you've overcome by the blood this morning?
Yes.
Now here's the second part.
Yes.
And by the word of their testimony.
Yes.
You may be going through situations right now. You may find yourself in a place of even sin, in a backslidden state. But testify even right there.
Yes, that's right.
I'm coming out.
Hey! Yes!
If you really got me, you just say, I'm out.
Hey,
I'm out.
Yes.
I'm out. I may be sick, but I'm healed.
Yes.
I may be broken, but the mender of broken pieces is in my life.
Yes. That's right.
That's your testimony.
Hallelujah.
Testify about your Redeemer.
That's right.
Testify about who he is.
Jesus. Thank you.
Someone said to me yesterday, he called, he's a friend of the ministry, Minister Ben, and he said, 2012, God is going to do some big things.
Amen. Yes.
And I said, he's already doing big things.
Yes. Yes.
What's today, February 15th? If you look 12, whatever, you see what I mean. If you look back over the past month and 12 days, God's done something for you. He's done something for you. Has he not? God has done something for you. Here's the testimony. Here's the testimony. If you don't know what to testify about and you're waiting to tell somebody about some miracle that happened, here's the testimony. God just gave me some lunch money. That's lunch money. Testify about the lunch money. February 12th. But look at the lunch money that God gave. If we're going to think big,
amen.
God has already started to move.
Amen.
Testify about what he's already done.
Yes.
In King James Version, it says, don't be afraid of their faces. Don't be afraid of their faces. Sometimes we don't tell our stories. We don't tell our testimonies because we're afraid of what other people are going to think, what they're going to do. And you know, sometimes you start talking to somebody about God, they just get all uncomfortable.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. You just get all, start to cringe. But don't be afraid of their faces. If I was afraid of your faces, most of the stuff that I say to you, I probably wouldn't every Sunday. That's all right, get quiet, I'm going to tell the truth. If I was afraid of your faces, I wouldn't come in here and say that today's a good day.
Right. Amen.
That's right. God.
If I was to look at your faces, sometimes I wouldn't say that Jesus was in the building.
Amen.
If I was afraid of your faces. But I'm not.
Yes.
You've got to be able to look at people's faces but still touch base with their spirit.
Yes.
Their faces may say, I don't want to hear it. But their spirit says, I need to hear about the goodness of the Lord. Don't be afraid of their faces. Will you tell your story?
Yes.
You got a Redeemer.
Yes.
Will you tell your story?
Yes.
Will you tell what you've been through? on Friday night, I went to New York and I almost didn't go, but there's a college ministry. They're so encouraged by everything that's going on at Finisher, so drove up to Dobbs Ferry, New York, and I couldn't believe the boldness, and I wouldn't even call boldness, but just honesty, of these redeemed. They got up there, these 19, 20-year-olds, saying the things that they've been delivered from. Every spirit you can think of, they named it. Every demonic spirit that you can think of, they named it.
Jesus.
And they did it, and they were so proud about it. Grab the mic and say, let me tell you what God did for me. I stand before you. Say, I've been through this, that. God brought me through this, that. And even if they might still be struggling with certain things, they overcame them.
Yes.
By the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony.
Yes, Lord. That's right. Yes. Hallelujah.
Ride through. Run this race proclaiming his goodness and that you're coming out.
Amen.
What are you going to do with your story? What are you going to do with the information that you have? That he was beaten so that you could be whole.
Thank you, Jesus.
He was wounded so that you could be healed. What are you going to do with it?
Sure.
Testify.
Yes.
Testify.
Yes.
Thank God. Testify for the lunch money.
That's right.
And knowing that the best is yet to come.
Yes.
Testify now. If you're faithful over a few things, I'm going to make you rule over a bunch.
Yes.
People wonder why we do so much to this little place that we have. Why you spend hours every week putting up banners. We were here yesterday painting stuff that the building owners, they didn't even know we were painting. We were helping them out.
Amen.
Listen to me. It was paint that was chipping and falling from the ceiling. And we were painting it up on the walls. Y'all probably didn't even notice. It was brighter out there because we painted up the patches that were on this front wall. They didn't ask us to. They didn't pay us to do it. Why? We're being thankful over the lunch money.
Amen. Yes. That's right.
Perhaps you're waiting for that big testimony to come. And for some odd reason, you may have failed to recognize that you're still alive.
Amen.
And that you don't have to be. If you want to, if you want to call that lunch money, okay. But that's a big deal to me. That's a big deal to me. Then we're going to testify. We're going to tell our stories. Share with others, if we want the goodness of the Lord to reign and rule on this earth, we want this whole earth to be filled with his glory.
Yes.
It ain't going to happen if we keep our mouths shut, folks.
Right.
Scripture says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face. Stop right there. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. When we keep our mouths shut about what God has done for us, unbelievers will see us and they will try to give credit to luck,
yes,
to chance.
Yes.
They'll try to give credit to any other spirit that may not be of God.
Yes.
That's not our truth.
Yes.
That's not our truth. But if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face. When you humble yourself, you're saying, God, it's not me, it was all you.
That's right, that's right.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Looking at the early revivals. Powerful revivals. It always started with one. Revival always starts inside of you. And what happened was that in the midst of revival getting ready to start, preachers, pastors, leaders would begin to publicly repent. They wouldn't even know what they were doing. Imagine that. Imagine that. You on a street revival, and you see the bishops up there just repenting to God. They're being very vocal about it. They're being very honest. They didn't care about the faces. They said there's certain people who would overhear what they repented to. Whoa, really? Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If you're college students, if you want to see the glory of God on your campus, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. It's going to start with you.
Yes, yes, Lord.
through opening up your mouth, telling people about the goodness of the Lord. Thank God for the lunch money. Testify about that. Testify about the Word of God.
That's right. Yes.
You hear me? Testify about the Word of God.
Yes.
If you came here this morning looking for a sit-down time and a regular traditional service, you get in the Word right now, then we're going to leave.
That's right.
This is it. Testify about the Word of God.
Amen.
Galatians chapter 6, it talks about the person who feeds you, who teaches you. They say, one more version says to provide for them. We're going to talk about that. But it says, another version says to share all good things with them. Perhaps you don't know what to testify about. You can't think of one thing to share. Testify about the Word of God. Testify about that Word. That Word speaks to you late in the midnight hour when you're singing loudly in your bed, as the Bible tells us to do. And although you may need a healer, you open up the Bible and you start reading about worship, and the Word reveals to you exactly what you need.
Amen.
Testify about the Word.
Amen.
What happens when people preach the gospel, and even for you who watch preachers and teachers and services on TV, online, I do too. Testify about that. You know what happens when those preachers get off stage and those ministers get off stage? When these people minister, you know what happens to them? You know what happens to me? The enemy will try to tell people who teach, you ain't say nothing. You ain't do nothing. What happens to you when you share your testimony, when you share the gospel? You ain't say nothing. You didn't get through to anyone. Testify about that. Those who teach you, share all good things with them. Share all good things with them. When you watch Bishop Jakes on TV and something really blesses your life and you go into a praise and a worship, write him a letter. Send him an email. Testify about that. Start there. Every now and then, I leave here at the end of service. There's one person that I know if it was a good day. Because this person would say, that was good. When this person don't say it, I say, Lord, every time I can leave here with my head held up high when this person comes up to me, says that was a good word. But when they don't say it, it's like, hey, I'm going through my mind. I'm afraid to watch the video. But testify about the Word of God. You've got a testimony. You've got a testimony. Testify about the lunch money. Testify about the Word of God. Word of God speaks to you. Word of God speaks. Perhaps you need a healer. You get to the Word of God and sees that He's more than that. He can be just more than that to you. Get to the Word of God. Reminds you of who He is and who you are. Reminds you of who you are. You start testifying about the Word, watch the Word start working for you.
Amen. Yes.
Somebody say, let the word
do the work.
Testify about it. The Word is working in your life.
Yes.
Thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light to my path. Get the Word. Get the Word. What are you going to do with the information that you have?
Testify.
You're going to testify. You've been indicted, but the chains aren't broken. You've been bought. Your freedom has been bought. Therefore, let nothing stand in the way of you and that freedom.
Yes.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're being whole. Let nothing stand in the way of that. Amen?
Amen.
I know what this is, so I'm going to let it.
A year ago, I got up and I said to my husband, I know where I'm going to be next week. You're going to be homeless or no food. But I said, this is done. I'm here to say, when you pray and you believe, anything is possible. Yes. A year later,
amen.
You don't need to win the lotto to live in your dream house.
Yes.
I just moved into my dream house.
Oh,
I did. Single mom, proud of it. Next year is our first anniversary. have some great teachers. I went to school the next day. I said, this is what's going to happen in my house. I need some great supporters. I have Miss Matt and a whole bunch of teachers that watch on school.
Yes.
A year later, no job. Great family. Found a great church in November. Looked at this house at 10 Amelia last year and prayed and prayed and prayed. And like I said, no job. You don't need a ladder. Just pray and believe. There's no way in our dream house. On Martin Luther King Day, we got our keys to move in our dream house. Nice house. Fancy yard for our dog that God blessed us with. Faith is her name.
Oh.
And she is precious. And of course, you know my three kids. A few weeks ago, we were still watching TV. And I think Pastor was talking about this. My son just jumps up. I owe no man nothing. Happy anniversary to me.
Yes.
Amen. You got a testimony. You got a testimony. All right? You can sit down for a few more moments. You got a testimony. That's it. Hallelujah. Things that you've gone through in life and you thought they were just going to be too hard to bear.
Yes.
Song says, but I remembered hearing in God's word that he wouldn't put more on me than I can bear.
Yes.
Believe it or not, you're strong enough for what you're going through.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
But not by yourself.
Right.
But with
right.
God, all things are possible.
That's right. Amen.
Run with God.
It's
for your good. The indictment, the cuffs that were put on you, the chains that were put on you, he allowed it. God allowed it. It's for your good, but for his glory. Gotten to this realization that your freedom has been bought. Now allow those chains to be broken. For your good, but for his glory. God gets all the glory.
Yes, 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 yes.
God gets all the glory. Book of Nehemiah tells us that Ezra lifted up those hands and said, amen. That word amen means it is so.
Yes.
It is so. Even in your situation, have the ability to say amen. I pray that over you. It is so.
Yes.
That means yes. Hey, Lord. So this time, ladies and gentlemen, from this day forth, when faced with calamity, may you be able to say yes.
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 Just say yes. Just say yes. This time I'm going to obey.
Yes.
This time I will obey.
Yes.
This time I won't try to get myself up out of it. This time I won't try to make a way for myself, but I'm going to allow you to be the way maker. That's who you are.
Yes.
In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me. For your good, for his glory. Change that perspective, all right? Life ain't been so bad.
Amen.
Has not been so bad.
That's right.
Life has not been so rough and tough. This past week hasn't been bad.
Mm-hmm.
The hell that you're facing in your house ain't so bad. Light affliction.
Yeah.
Perspective. Perspective. For your good, for his glory. Speak to those mountains and say, be thou removed, be cast into the sea. Speak to that foolishness that you're going through.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Say, God's going to get the glory out of this.
That's right.
And then testify about it.
Yes.
All right? You're coming out. You're coming out strong.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's all right. It's all right. You made it through. You made it through. So glad I made it.
Thank you.
Look at people who take the situation into their own hands.
Yes.
Commit suicide. Of course, you know, we all know and we heard about Whitney Houston. Who knows what was going through her mind over her lifetime. The chains that were on her.
Yes.
She says she knew Jesus. But you can know Jesus and still not have the ability to be free. But that comes down to you. Choose freedom. Choose freedom. You don't choose freedom, you're still going to be on trial. Right? But thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph. You've got a Savior, my brothers and sisters, who's your Redeemer.
Amen.
He's justified you.
Praise God.
Yes.
He's your bail sponsor.
Yes.
Paid that bail.
Yes,
you've got a Savior.
Yes.
He's a lawyer.
Praise God.
You've got a Savior.
Glory.
He's both the judge and the jury.
Yes. Amen.
That's your King.
Yes.
That's your Jesus. That's your King. What are you going to do with the information? Share your story. If you've been delivered, tell it. God brought you out, tell it. You had certain issues that were weighing you down, but God has brought you out, tell it. Shame the devil. The devil wants you to keep that locked up. Because when you open up your mouth and start to tell of your deliverance, other people are going to get blessed. Other people are going to react, and that's just what the devil does not want. Amen?
Amen.
They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of their testimony. I feel a good old-fashioned testimony service coming on in the next couple of weeks. You're going to do it.
Glory.
Got to remind the folks to hope, believe in God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Stand up on your feet. We're getting ready to get out of here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's it. That's it. Glory to God. Did you get something this morning?
Yes.
It's cool flowing with the Spirit. You get exactly what you need. Right? That's it. You got a story to tell. Get ready to write those books in Jesus' name. This week, some of y'all are going to open up blogs online. Get ready. Okay? Really? Seriously. You got a story to tell. You got a story to tell. Many of us can fit in those categories. Things have just been driving you crazy. This is your day. And I speak over you right now. Say, may the God of peace, peace and joy, just garrison your heart. And just renew your spirit. That's what it is. Your spirit needs to be renewed.
Yes.
So joy is rising. Peace is rising. Your spirit is getting renewed. The Holy Spirit that God has given you is more powerful than your situation, more powerful than your pain, more powerful than that sickness. So receive it now. This week, you're going to walk in it. This week, things are going to seem a little bit lighter. This week, you're going to be able to skip a little bit. Smile a little more. Laugh a little more. Why? Because your perspective has changed. And you're looking at your situation. You're saying, for my good, but for God's glory. This week, you're going to be obedient. You're going to allow God to be the way maker.
Yeah, that's right.
You're going to allow God to be your bridge. This week, you're making this decision that you're going to remain in the will of God. And as you remain in the will of God, Genesis tells us that everything you need will be brought to you. Remain faithful. Testify about the word of God. Testify about that lunch money. The best is yet to come. Are you ready for the full course meal?
Yes. Yes.
Are you ready for that?
Yes.
I will bless your name. 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 God, you are so good. God, you are so good. God, you are so good. I will bless your name. You are my best friend. Lord, you are my best friend.
Thank you.
You are my best friend. I will bless your name. Lord, you saved my life.
Yes.
Lord, you saved my life.
Yes.
Lord, you saved my life. So I will bless your name. I will say yes, 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 Lord.
Yes.
I will say yes, 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 Lord. I will say yes, 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 Lord. This time I will obey. Come on. I will say yes, 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 Lord. I will say yes, yes. Job and your family, peace be unto you. In your mind, in your heart, in your spirit, a renewed spirit, peace be unto you. Peace be unto you. Do you receive it this morning? The devil wants to keep your mouth shut and to keep you from testifying, but open up your mouth and let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Testify about the lunch money, all right? Has God done something for you in 2012? Testify. Share it. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you for your Holy Spirit that can do it so much better than we can. God, we thank you for dismissing our plans and rolling with yours. We praise you and we worship you. We give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praise. This week shall be the best week that we have seen ever before. We thank you for renewed spirits in you. To you be all the glory, all the honor, all the power, all the praise. Thank you for keeping us. Thank you for watching over us. May these minds that are also in us be the same mind that is in Christ Jesus. We thank you for your word. We thank you for your word, Father. The flowers and the grass may wither and fade, but your word remains forever. So we thank you for that. This week, we're going to get into the word more. May we be reminded of who you are and the lamp and the light that your word provides. We expect great things this week. A new sense of joy and a new sense of peace. Wherever we go, Father, may we be light, a light in this dark world. And may our testimonies bless the lives of others. Hallelujah. If you agree with that, say yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Say yes,